Let me tell you something, yeah. The main motive of Bahamians in the next general election is going to be to vote the FNM out just to investigate what they did with the billions borrowed, the billions collected, the VAT hike, and the Oban deal. We want to know the truth about all these things, and the only way to find it out is to vote them out. So all these lies they're trying to tell, the Bahamians ain't green and they ain't dumb. We want to know. Inquiring minds want to know. Even the punch tired of their jokey ass. At this juncture in history, there is no way that spite, vindictiveness, lies, and deceit are going to work anymore. Not in this country where the poor people are suffering and the middle class has been destroyed. Our jobs, our unemployment rate is almost 65%. There is no way that all those persons fired are going to go to the polls and vote for menace. So I don't care how much lies they spread. I don't care how much propaganda they use. I don't care how much of the treasury they give away. Because they only gave the Bahamian people the money what they work for and what they take from them. They took care of their special interest groups and had no time for Bahamians who were suffering in Dorian. They didn't care whether you had food in your house when they were locking down for COVID-19. And they didn't give two shits about how you travel outside this country and come back with no COVID tests on a 72-hour policy. Yes, my leader, Philip Brave Davis, did way more for us in Grand Bahama and Abaco than Menace has yet to do. Brave was on the ground from day one. Okay? Issuing out food and building supplies. Himself. A caring leader was on the ground with packages of food to deliver out. Personally, to the shut-ins, to those persons who had no vehicle, and the persons who showed up, they did not care. Didn't care. FNM or PLP, give it to you. But you see, when this jokey government talking about they giving out all kind of enhancements and this and that, they making sure they're giving it to the FNM. They ain't getting it to us. Okay? Because only them supposed to survive in this country, because only them telling the lies to support the party. So they can sweeten the pot for their own, but not for us. Because those of us who know the truth know this is the worst leadership in the history of this country. And Bahamians ain't fool no more. They ain't falling for that. That story would he tell in Los Andres? That story would he tell to Cat Island? That story would he tell the East Grand Bahama about the Oban deal? Bahamians ain't buying that no more. That promise about an over-the-hill VAT-free zone? Bahamians ain't buying that no more. We still remember from the hill to the valley who y'all firing. We still remember all those that y'all terminated. We still remember those people that y'all left to drown in Abaco. We still remember the dead in the trailer. We still remember those buried without identification after 8 months with flies all over their bodies. We remember. So don't think for a moment that anybody forget who Menace really is. He need to look in the mirror and wonder how he got in this position. Greedy for the Bahamian people things. And don't want us to have a piece of our own pie.